Hello everyone, this is Kumar Saurabh from the Code World. Today we are going to learn how to get started with the Codechef. Codechef is a competitive programming site where coders from different reputed institutes come and code there. It hosts many competitive coding competitions, so we need to learn how to program over there. So let's get started with our first problem on Codechef. To get started, first of all, open your browser and type www.codechef.com. After opening the page, if you don't have the account, create an account by clicking on new user. New user, click on that, and then you can sign up there using your Google Plus account or Facebook account or GitHub account. You can sign up there by Google Plus, Facebook or GitHub. Or you can fill up the form over here and get registered. After getting registered, you need to log in. So let's log in. So you can fill your username here or password and then log in. So after logging in, you will see your account like this, and then you can for the first problem, we will start from beginner section in the practice. So click on that beginner. Okay, so here is the beginner section. To sort out the problems from easy to hard, we need to click on successful submission. So click on successful submissions. So after clicking on successful submission, here is the easiest problem on this site. So we are going to solve this problem. So to solve this problem, click on the problem. Okay, to then first of all, read the problem carefully. Read the problem carefully. The problem statement. So what it is saying here, your program is to use the brute force approach. What is brute force? Actually, it is error and trial method, as you have learned many times. So means you will try every input and corresponding output. Okay, so in order to find the answer to life, the universe and everything more precisely, rewrite small numbers from input to output. Rewrite small numbers. Actually, it is saying what? That you have to, whatever input is given, you have to make that output the same number as output, and stop processing input after 42. Means you need to stop there when you get 42. Okay, so all numbers are integers, input integers of one or two digits. So let's see the input section. In input section, there are several numbers like 1, 2, 88, 42, 99, and then in output 1, 2, 88. So what it is going to do means here is actually it is taking the input till 88 and printing that, and after 42, from 42, it is not printing that and it is not taking the input. So we need to code over that. So first of all, make your flow chart or pseudo code like that, and then you need to code. And if you have laptop, then you can code on your editors like Dev C++, Turbo C++ or different kind of editors. And if you don't have the laptop to code, you can use the IDE here. So to open the IDE, let's again open codechef.com. Then in practice section, you will find the code compile and run. So click on that. First of all, choose your language over here. Choose language like I want to choose C. So I will search for the C, and here I got C. Okay, I got the C. And first of all, be careful that you don't need to write void main. Okay, always write int main in C and return 0. So be careful about that. And to code, let's start our code here. So to get started, first of all we need to take the numbers at input. So let's take a number int x, which will be our number int x. Then we need to take input in that, so we will use scanf function. Okay, then what it is saying, we need to stop till we don't get 42, means till 42 we need to run a loop. So we will run a loop till 42. So and if it means before it is not equal to 42, we need to print that. So let's print that. Printf %d then x. Okay, but here is an error. What is the error? After every output it is changing the line. So here we need to add an escape sequence to change the line. Okay, we added the escape sequence. So after, and then after check means printing, then we again need to take that input. Okay, so take that input again, scanf %d comma address of x. Okay, so I think our code is complete for the first program. So to check whether it is right or wrong, just click on this box custom input, click on that, and then copy the inputs from here. So let's copy the inputs from here and paste it over here. So and then run. So let's run the code. I think it is right. Let's see. So after running, it gives the output 1288 for the corresponding input, and here output is also 1288. So I think our code is right, but there are various test cases also. So you also means for before submission, check over different outputs, like I am changing the inputs. So for the corresponding input, output is, I think, yeah, it is printing before 42. So I think it is correct. So if you are sure about submission, then copy the code from here. Copy the code from here, and then in the problem section you will find the submit button here or over here. Okay, so you can choose any one of them. So I am choosing this one, so click on that and then paste it and choose the language over here also. Be careful, choose the language C. So I am choosing C, and again choose the language over here. So C. Okay, now you can submit your problem. So let's submit it. And I think it is checking over different sample inputs. So it is checking. Let's see what will happen. Oh my god, we got the correct answer. So happy coding, and this green tick will keep you motivated to code into your Codechef. So happy coding, and please support the CodeBird team to get more knowledge and videos like this. Okay, so thank you and happy coding. Okay, thank you.